Good morning, everyone. In this session, we are going to discuss with the next chapter, chapter 5, the impact of British rule. Already we have completed the expansion of the British rule. Already we have completed, and also we understood the story, okay, we understood the chapter. And after we are moving to the next unit, the impact of British rule. Okay, what happened here? Okay, let us see. First, before entering into this, let us see the in focus of the what we are going to see in this chapter. Okay, so come to the chapter. First one, we are going to see the exploitation of the peasants. Okay, the exploitation of the peasants. Peasants means the farmers. And this next one, growth of transport and industries. Growth of transport and industries. That's the second one. And the third one, the impact of education. Okay, so the impact of education. Last one, social and cultural changes. Okay, these are things that we are going to see in this chapter. And as you just study the timetable blockages, okay, Ijaradari system, permanent settlement, then Charter Act to initiate education activities, Raitwari settlement, Mahalwari settlement, then first railway line in India, woods dispatch, then drain of the world theory propounded by Dadabhai Nawroji, okay. And also before, I think one column is there, okay, This is a story of read the address by Lord Macaulay to the British Parliament and answer the question. Okay, already it is a Macaulay's address to the British Parliament on 2nd February 1885. Okay, so you just read and also write the answer. Okay, I will give some answers I will give. Okay, with this you just complete. Okay, and so first you read this paragraph, what is in the column. Okay. Just I will read, okay, just for a brief introduction, I will read. I have travelled across the length, okay, the Macaulay, okay, he travelled across the length and the breadth of India, and I have not seen one person who is a beggar, then who is a thief, such a wealth that I have seen in this country, such high moral values, and also people of India, we are having such moral values, and also when he is walking through India, he didn't find, okay, a person who is a beggar, and also who is a thief, okay, and he is saying, okay, people such of caliber, and also the people of India, okay, the Indians, we have such caliber, okay, caliber, and so that I do not think we would overconquer this country unless we break the very backbone of the nation, which is her spiritual and cultural heritage, and therefore I purpose that we replace her old and ancient education system. Okay, you just see, first of all, it is just like a changing, okay, he is saying, okay, so cultural heritage, and therefore I purpose that we replace her old and ancient education system, her culture, for if the Indians think that all that is foreign and English is good, and also the Indians thought, okay, English is the best, and also just they insisted, okay, they just like what is that we can say, just like they insert their education, okay, English is, because the English education, because they give importance to the Indians, no? They give importance to English education, okay. And so what is that? Indians think that that is foreign and English is good and greater than their own. And so we thought like this, okay. Then they will lose their self-esteem, their native culture, and they will become what we want them. I truly dominated nation. And so when English education came, and so just like we are thinking that, okay, that is the best one, English is the best one, and so we are not considering our language, okay. The priority is given to English, okay, that's why. So, come to the question. What was the only way in which the British could conquer India according to Lord Macaulay? So, you can write, and so from this column, you can write, okay, the first one you can write, to insert their education, okay. So, insert their education means British education, English education, system and culture, okay. So, we just like insert their education system and culture, that we can write in first, then culture in India, that you can say. Then, second one you can write, making English as the best language, okay. Making English as the best language, okay. First of things, I just said, you just write, okay. You just read this and write, okay. So, come to the paragraph, okay. So, 62 page number. The Queen's proclamation of 1858, Queen's means Elizabeth, okay. Queen Elizabeth, okay. 1858 had declared that the British government was responsible for the progress and welfare of the people in India. Did they obey or not, okay? Did they responsible for the welfare of the people in India? Because they were looking only for their personal interest, and also already we can see this, okay? They wanted to increase their industrial and commercial interest, okay? Just to read, then after that I will say, okay? So that is what the Queen's Proclamation, okay, in 1858 had declared that the British government was responsible for the progress and welfare of the Indian people. However, the policies adopted by the British rulers benefited the industrial and the commercial interest of the British people alone. Insistence by the British that only cash crops, they mainly focuses on cash crops. Why they focus on cash crops? That we can say because with this they can get a lot of money, a lot of income, and also that is for the personal profit, okay, personal, and also British people, okay, that is for the industry and the commercial interest, okay. So they give more importance to cash crops instead of food grains. That's only our agricultural field, okay, just destroyed very pathetically, and also they give more importance to cash crops. Like, which are the cash crops? We can say just like a tea, then indigo, jute, coffee, okay. So these are the cash crops, okay, and also this, okay, cotton also we can say, okay. So these are the cash crops, okay. They mainly focus on cash crops instead of food grains, okay. So see, like cotton, indigo take the place of food grains, destroy the self-sufficient village economy, and also the most of the people, they were depending on this, just like a food grains, and also they gave more importance to agriculture field. But they concentrated, they concentrated only cash crops. So the Indian people, okay, they destroyed the self-sufficient village economy, okay. Then frequent famines, okay, frequent famines means just like a poverty, okay. Poverty and the British apathy means not interested, okay. Apathy means not interested, okay, towards it, with no focus on improving agriculture, result in a great poverty and discontent among the masses. Masses means the commodity, and also it is saying that the British, they didn't take any responsibility for the welfare of the Indian people. They give more importance to the cash crops, okay, like tea, indigo, jute, coffee, and also they are not at all concentrating the agricultural field, just like a food grain. That's why there is a severe famine, and also as a result, there is a great poverty and discontent. Discontent means dissatisfaction among the masses. Masses means the community of India, okay, means community of the India, okay, that's why. So this is about the first paragraph. I think this is clear for you. We couldn't improve our agriculture because they are concentrating only cash crops only, and also they are not responsible for our just like a welfare of the Indian people. That's it. And also come to the next one, which is successive land revenue policy. The power of the zemindar and the wealth of the British increased by leaps and bounds. Leaps and bounds means very, very quickly, very rapidly, or very fastly, okay, fast process. Because with each successive land revenue policy, just like they can collect the tax, okay, land revenue policy, the power of zemindar and the wealth of the British, and also at the same time, zemindar and also the wealth of the British, they can increase, okay, they increased just like by leaps and bounds, very quickly, very fastly we can say, as did the exploitation of the peasant, okay, and also they exploited, okay, because this like for their personal purpose, just like a personal interest, the British and at the same time zemindars, okay, they destroyed, they exploited whom? The peasants. Peasant means farmers, okay, those who are working in the agriculture, or those who are working in the field, okay, they just defeated, they destroyed their life, peasants, okay. So peasants, by the moneylender and the zemindar, and also both of them, moneylender and also the zemindar. So in short we can say the British, they destroyed the peasants for their personal interest or personal growth, okay. And also for this, the British growth, okay, the British increased by leaps and bounds, so very quickly, okay, that's why. So come to the next one. While economically the British government looked into the interest of the British and the wealthy Indians like the zemindars, okay. And also here we can see that just like while economically, okay, in short we can say economically, just like in the British government, they focus on the just like their personal interest, okay, they are giving just like a, what is that, just like economically the British government looked into the interest of the British, at the same time the zemindars, they give importance to the just like English education, and also they brought English education to Indian people, okay, Indian people. Certain laws were passed with the promote schools and upliftment of women in India. Upliftment means it's like uplift, okay, upliftment of the woman. And also here we can see just like economically The Britishers are giving importance to their personal interest, but Zamindars, they give importance to the just like a Western empire, just like a, what is that, English education to the Indian people, and also they give more importance to the upliftment of the women, women, and also we can say they promoted schools and upliftment of women in India. They give more activities and also more programs to the women, that's all. So come to the main point, economic policy of the British. So what is the economic policy of the British and how to destroy the Indian people? Let us see. As the British secured political control over their Indian territories, the British secured the political control over the Indian territories. At the same time, we can see that its political architects began to feel the strain of the financial liabilities. At the same time, its political, it means the British political architects, architects, you know. So he found, he felt that the strain of the financial liabilities, so some financial problems are there, they have some financial problems. What is that? Which are the financial problems? Because the first one we can say, they had to bear a high cost of, the first one we can say, maintaining the administrative structure, that is the first one. Then war expenses, we can say, it is there in the textbook, and also funds for the purchase of the Indian goods for exporting to England, so for this they had to bear a high cost of amount, high cost of maintaining the administrative structure, the high cost, so with this they started looting, with this purpose they started looting India, although in this way, just like we can say with this policy, in short we can say with this policy, just like what is that, their policy ruined the traditional Indian economy which was agro-based, we are following agro, just like agriculture, and so we are giving more importance to agriculture. So this policy ruined, ruined the traditional Indian economy which was agro-based, because they are just like all the traditional goods, we are following, just like we have the traditional goods, just like spices and also all the things, just like a traditional, like cash crops like tea, indigo, jute, these things they will carry from, export from India in a very low price, and also from there they will sell it in a high price, the way, that's what it is saying, with this policy, their policy is going to the traditional Indian economy which was agro-based, so that's what you just study, and also it was there, how it was there before, village in India where, see the points, so village in India were primarily self-sufficient, that we know the self-sufficient, because just like I mainly concentrated on agriculture, so in the village everything, we know that, what is in village, and also units, agriculture and handicrafts being the main occupation of the majority of the people, and also those who are living in India, the traditional custom, in a traditional, we can say, traditional Indian economy, mainly the occupation, what is the occupation of the traditional occupation of the India, that we can say that agriculture and handicrafts are the, being the main occupations of the majority of the people, you just underline, that is the traditional Indian economy. In short, we can say the traditional economy is agriculture and handicrafts, that we can say, and also being the main occupation of the majority of the people, they are concentrating mainly the agriculture, then what happens, second, land revenue was collected by the landlord, before it was like this, collected by the landlord or by the officials, officials appointed by the king, mainly in king, mainly in king, and also king is responsible for that, and also mostly the farmers owned the land they tilled, and also in the ancient time we know that the most the farmers owned the land they tilled, so where they are tilling, that's the land is owned by them, the owners are they, them, so that's the answer. So let us see how much British policies have negative impact on Indian economy. Let us see British policy until 1793. I think this economic policy is clear for, if you ended out, you just approach, so come to the next one, ijaradari system, so when the East India Company obtained a Diwani rights, what is Diwani rights? That is a tax, already in the before, already was, Awadh, Shala, and also they defeated the Maratha, they have to give the tax, just like as a result, they have to give the tax right, Diwani rights, same thing. When the East India Company obtained, already they obtained the tax, Diwani means tax of Bihar, Bengal and Orissa, in 1765, they continued with the traditional methods of revenue collection, they continued the same thing, what is that, the method of revenue collection, because already they have the right, Cartwright Diwali right okay that's it but the officials of the company observed huge amount observed means just like what is a taken okay just like a collected okay observed okay huge amounts from the peasants so they are just like destroying exploiting the peasants peasants means farmers also working in the ground or also working in the agriculture okay so observed means collected huge amounts from the peasants unofficially which added to their personal wealth and also they are collecting not officially unofficially that's what it is saying they are looting and destroying the farmers okay unofficially which added to their personal wealth and also it is for their personal wealth not for any officials or something it is unofficially it happened okay and what happened however till the 1770s the company's income from land revenue was too little so at last the company's income from land revenue was too little okay too little then what happened which diminished further because of the massive famine and also how it happened why the revenue was too little because of the diminished okay because it is the massive famine is what is like a group just like a poverty because of the poverty because already we have seen just like the peasants just like the company officials and officials of the company observed collected huge amount from the peasants unofficially and also which added to their personal wealth and also they are not alone giving the company that is for their personal wealth okay that's only then because of this the company's income from land revenue was too little and also then at last because all others are unofficially the others not just like the officials they are looting and also they are discriminating peasants okay so at last what happened there is a massive famine means complete poverty okay the group of people that is massive okay complete famine then what happened hence Warren Hastings so at the same time Warren Hastings underline okay Warren Hastings introduced the ijaradari system okay so you just underline so Warren Hastings introduced the ijaradari system okay according to which right that also you just write what is ijaradari system underline who introduced the ijaradari system that is Warren Hastings and so what is ijaradari system see according to which the right to revenue collection so according to this which right to revenue collection was given to the highest bidder okay bidder means a person especially just like a tar assign auction okay that you can see okay bidder means just like a contractor we can say contract okay bidder for a period of 5 years these bidders were called the contractors okay so bidder means were called as contractors that we can say okay so that is ijaradari system so what is ijaradari system according to which the right to revenue collection was given to the highest bidder for a period of 5 years okay these bidders were called contractors okay I think ijaradari system is clear for you and also come to the last point 3 more points are there let us see then it will be very clear and also in this system okay this system failed because of what already you have seen just like in the first beginning already you have seen ijaradari system because of the unofficial just like officials in the British is the officials in the company they are collecting from the peasants unofficially and also it is given it is ordered with their personal growth so because why is it and also after that the company because the company is getting the less price means less land revenue and also the land revenue was too little and also because of the what is that massive famine so at last who introduced this system ijaradari system Warren Hastings introduced this system and also according to the system what is that which was right to revenue collection was given to the highest bidder for a period of 5 years okay so the bidder called the contractors already has seen and also this system failed because of the first one bidding was often not related to the actual productivity of the land and is the next one because for example you can say because here we can see one land okay from here we will get a lot of money at the same time from the next land no they are won't get much money because someday there won't be much water or something so they cannot give the money okay because and also the according to this Israeli system all have to pay the equal tax okay so I think in some way that is not good because some of them will get a lot of money some of them will get less money that's only first one the bidding was often not related to the actual productivity of the land next one the ijaradari okay ijaradars were not interested and also ijaradars means the person okay groups no Hijradars were not interested in making improvements in the land as it was auctioned at regular intervals. And so they didn't like it. They cannot get the land again to collect. Okay, just like what is that? According to the system, because already it is auctioned, you know, auction. And also when they are putting it for auction, I think sometimes they don't get it repeat. Okay, just like they couldn't take it, take their land again. Okay, because that's what it is saying. The Hijradars were not interested in making improvements in the land as it was auctioned at regular intervals. Okay, so sometimes after auction, sometimes if they have the less money, they won't get the land again. That's what. Okay. Then the contractors exploited the peasants to extract more and more revenue. That is the next one. Actually, this system failed. The contractors already, buyers already, we can see, you know, in this system, we can see the buyer for a period of 5 years, the buyer were known as the contractors. Okay. So the contractors means the buyers. Okay. Contractors exploited the peasants. They also exploited the farmers to extract. Extract means collect more and more revenue. And also they collected more and more revenue from the peasants. That's why this system failed. So I think with these things are clear for you. If you have any doubt regarding these things, you just contact. So with this, I am going to wind up the session. So thank you.